Hi, folks. I'm Gene Okerlund, and this is WWE Confidential. Tonight, we're behind the scenes with Chris Benoit as he does his best Rocky impersonation. We'll also catch up with the other Rocky as the People's Champ walks tall on the red carpet of his new movie. And the Hart brothers, Brett and Owen, duel inside a steel cage in this week's classic match. But first up, a story you'll need to see to believe. Competing in athletics at any level requires varying degrees of commitment. But if you want to be the best, you need to work hard to hone your craft. For high school senior Kyle Maynard, he needs to work even harder. Kyle is not only a fan of the WWE, but he is also one of the top high school wrestlers in the state of Georgia in his weight class. So why does Kyle need to work harder than anyone else, you might ask? Like I said initially, you'll need to see it to believe it.
My name is Kyle Maynard. I'm a senior at Collins Hill High School and a 4-year member of the wrestling team there. It's technically called congenital amputation. That's the name of the condition. And it's just really shortened limbs, you know, arms at the end at the elbows and legs at the end about the knees. And I was born that way. The doctors really don't have any idea what caused it.
At first, we wondered what types of things he would be able to do and what types of limitations he might have. But just as a baby, he started crawling just like any other baby, and he kept advancing just right along with the other kids his age.
It definitely doesn't inhibit me in many things. I've tried to adapt, and you know, as far as physical feeling goes, I think that it's, you know, to me it's normal, and that's the way my whole life is. It's just about the pursuit of normalcy. On a normal day, I'd wake up, go to school, go through the whole school day thinking about practice. I started wrestling when I was a sixth grader. It was right after football ended. There's like that physical nature of it, and you know, it was really attracting to me right off the bat, even though in sixth and halfway through seventh grade, I didn't win a match.
I actually was a little concerned about him wrestling because it's one of the few sports where you're out there one-on-one, and if you lose, you end up, you know, getting your butt kicked by another guy. So from an ego perspective, you know, I was a little concerned about that.
When he first started wrestling and he wasn't winning, his goal, he made a goal for himself, and that was to never be pinned. And he wasn't pinned. As a matter of fact, I don't believe he's ever been pinned.
It was incredible to win my first match. You know, it came about a year and a half after I started wrestling, but once it finally happened, then I started winning more and more after that. When I wrestle, I try to make sure that my body's in the best possible condition that it can be. I put in a lot of extra time, doing a lot of extra conditioning work, a lot of extra weight room work. So, you know, I want to be stronger and faster and in better shape than my opponents. And I think those advantages kind of even out the disadvantages in the playing field. I would say that my technique is really controlled aggression. You know, you can't go out there crazed, you know, do anything stupid. But for me, you know, I try to wrestle as intensely as I can. Quite a few of my opponents, they'll just be completely skeptical and wonder if they should take it easy on me. It's really interesting. You know, some kids are overly aggressive, some kids are overly passive, and some kids just kind of have a right balance if they scouted me out. When I first started, I didn't think that would be that well at all. Eventually got to the point where, you know, I was working hard enough that it paid off. I was probably about 3 or 4 years old when I first fell in love with WWE. I got to see the Ultimate Warrior, and he was in Fort Wayne, Indiana. That's where we used to live. I just thought that was the most amazing thing, just because it's just a live and, you know, vivid sport. You know, it's got so much heart and passion by the superstars in it. And I just like the fact that it really does give wrestling a lot of the spotlight that the sport really doesn't receive elsewhere. You know, when I look at those guys and the work that they put in, you know, the physical condition that they get their bodies into in order to prepare, you know, for their events, and, you know, I look at me and I just think that, you know, I need to put in the same effort too. I'm extremely excited to meet everybody.
Well, we're happy that you're here.
I'm happy to be here. This is incredible.
How old are you right now?
Heroes. I'll be 18 this month.
So you talk about your heroes, you talk about, like, you know, The Rock,
yep.
Stone Cold Steve Austin, The Coach. I mean, the list goes on and on.
What's your name?
I'm Kyle.
Kyle?
Yeah.
Here to pick up some chicks, Kyle?
Yeah, I hope so.
Well, if you can, come on my way.
All right.
Okay.
Very nice to meet you.
It's very nice to meet you.
I read a nice article about you in the Charlotte Observer.
Oh, really?
Yeah. What year are you in school?
I'm a senior this year.
Well, yeah. Last year,
just finished our class season.
Nice to meet you.
Clay.
Yeah, I wrestled in high school 2 years. I didn't do too well. That's why I do this. I didn't get that. I went to state twice, but I never had a record like that. That's awesome.
Are you really that tough?
I think so. Huh?
Are you really that tough?
Oh, yeah.
I actually got to see your son wrestle in a tournament.
My little one?
Yeah.
Oh, really? I used to bring him down here all the time.
Yep.
At the AU tournaments.
Yeah.
He was a freshman this year. Want to try me one time real quick? What's going on? You doing all right?
Yeah, just hanging out back here.
Yeah?
How are you?
Cool, man. I'm great, yeah. Good. Hanging out for the show?
Yeah.
Definitely. All right. I hear it's pretty impressive what you do. That's amazing. It is.
Thank you.
Right?
Yeah.
Very impressive.
Yeah, I've been watching him since I was like three.
I think we have your character, man.
It's turning us off. You're the second guy that said that to me. And I know that's supposed to be endearing, but that makes me feel better.
Oh, don't hurt him.
What up, dog?
Oh, really?
How much are you benching now? I seen you benching it.
I haven't maxed yet because I'm afraid I'm going to break the chains, but I
got
360 up three times.
Wow. That's cool, man.
Yeah.
Impressive, man.
Thank you.
Takes a lot of heart, brother. What do you do?
Yeah.
How are you, sir?
Great. It's great to meet you.
Good to meet you. Your inspiration. How you doing, man?
Hey.
Heard a lot about you. How you doing?
Awesome to meet you, Steve.
Nice to meet you, too. Oh, wow. I'm on a shirt. Just came up with this, and it does smell like a second one made. It's a prototype, and this is probably the first one made, so there you go.
Wow.
Thank you.
Those guys have been my heroes since I was like 3 and 4 years old. I've always looked up to those guys, and actually meet them, they were just so personable and, you know, so kind.
You know, it's hard to envision myself as any type of, you know, inspiration just because I see myself as completely normal. But I, you know, it draws tremendous inspiration to me when I have anybody else tell me that, you know, my story has impacted them in some way. I think that's the most incredible thing that anybody can say to anybody else.
When we return, The Rock is walking tall on the big screen.
It's my premiere. We're at the Man's Shiny Theater. I want to roll up, feel that intensity. The band's going crazy. It's awesome. You were standing here playing pocket pool as you usually do.